Greetings, everyone. My name is Stefan Sorger. I'm an instructor for data analytics and other courses. I'll be taking you through some basic steps for dimension reduction using R. We've made every effort to ensure accuracy and relevancy of the content. Nevertheless, we cannot control how the information is being used, so we assume no liability for the use of this information. In this presentation, I'll take you through some basic steps for dimension reduction using R, including introducing dimension reduction and how it's similar to Dostadning, introducing the sample data set we'll use for dimension reduction, exploring it to find possible correlations in the data in its variables, executing the principal components analysis, or PCA, in R, and plotting out the results to show you how well PCA works. Our goal with dimension reduction is to explain the variance in the data using fewer variables. Dimension reduction is sometimes referred to as feature selection or feature extraction. We do this because we can encounter problems if our data contains excessive variables. Extra variables can result in collinearity, which essentially means redundant variables. With extra variables, the models just don't seem to work. They take a long time to run, and we really don't understand which variables are important and which are not. The situation is similar to decluttering an apartment. We need to ask ourselves, do we truly need to keep every back issue of every newspaper? The Swedes have a word for this, Dostadning, which literally means death cleaning. Dostadning means cleaning up your house before you die to spare your family of this chore. Data analytics is no different. Our goal is to declutter the data to get rid of variables not needed. We can get some quick wins by a quick examination of the data. First, we can consider removing variables that are virtually the same for every record. We can find this out by running summary statistics and identifying variables where the min and max values are nearly identical. Second, we can simplify categorical variables. For example, one categorical variable could be represented by 6 dummy variables in R. One of those dummy variables could have only 3 instances of being true in the entire data set. Consider grouping these instances into another category. And third, we recommend those with domain knowledge review the data to assess the relevancy of the variables. We demonstrate the process with an example. We'll use the dataset Wine from the UC Irvine Machine Learning Repository. The Wine dataset contains data on 13 different chemical constituents found in wine that was produced in a certain region of Italy. That region is known for 3 different varieties or cultivars. Our goal is to be able to distinguish one cultivar from another based on the chemical properties. The 13 variables in the dataset include the level of alcohol, malic acid, ash, and so forth. The data is formatted using comma-separated values, or CSV, as shown. The data contains 178 samples, or records, with 13 variables, one for each chemical constituent, plus the first variable in each row, which is the cultivar that identifies the variety. The 1 in the first column represents cultivar 1, or CV1. We also have cultivar 2, or CV2, and cultivar 3, or CV3. We read in the data using the read.table function in R. Because the data does not include a header row with the variable names, we also name the variables. We obtain the syntax for all the functions shown in this presentation from the R manual, available at stat.ethz.ch/r-manual. The first line of code reads in the data. Note the Uniform Resource Locator, or URL, pointing to the UCI Machine Learning Repository. The second line of code assigns the column names, one for each variable, beginning with the cultivar CVS code and continuing with 13 chemical constituents. We can check the data for correlations, which can be interpreted as potential extra variables. We check the correlations using the core function in R. We display the correlations using a heat map using the heat map function in R. The line of code shown computes the correlations in the Wine dataset we read in, and then plots out a heat map of the correlations it found. Here we see the resulting heat map. Dark squares represent strong correlations. We can see that the heat map includes several strong correlations. We now introduce principal components analysis, or PCA. Its purpose is to reduce the number of variables by finding a new, smaller set of variables. The principal components found by the PCA process are orthogonal, or perpendicular, to each other to maximize efficiency. We define efficiency here as the fewest number of variables to describe the maximum amount of variance. The chart shows the concept. The chart shows two original dataset variables, variable A and variable B, on the X and Y axes, respectively. The principal components analysis process creates principal components such as Z1 and Z2. PCA aligns Z1 with the highest variability in the data, as we can see on the chart. It then creates Z2, which is orthogonal to Z1, to explain a bit more of the variability. Overall, PCA is essentially a linear algebra exercise and can even be done using the solver function found in Microsoft Excel. We recall our objective with this data set as identifying the three cultivars, or varieties, based on the chemical data. To make it easier to distinguish the three cultivars, we will declare three classes, one for each cultivar, CV1, CV2, and CV3. To do so, we use the factor function in R, which is good for declaring a small number of distinct values. The line of code shows the factor function being used against the CVS variable in the wine dataset. In assigning the result to a variable, we will call classes. We execute principal component analysis using the PCA function prcomp included with R. We recommend normalizing the data to a common scale so that the PCA process will not overweight variables which happen to have larger values. To normalize the data, we apply the scale function in R. We do not want to normalize the CVS variable because we need to know if it is a 1, a 2, or a 3 to designate CV1, CV2, or CV3 respectively. The CVS variable is located in the first column, as you recall from the data format shown earlier. We tell R not to include the first column by indicating a negative 1 in the code, i.e. the negative 1 in the brackets. We ask R to give us the summary statistics of the PCA analysis using the summary function. The summary shows us the cumulative proportion that each principal component, or PC, contributes. From the R output, we see that PC1 gives us 36.2% cumulative contribution, which we interpret as PC1 having the power to explain 36.2% of the variance of the data. Moving on to the other principal components, we see that PC2 takes us to 55.4% cumulative contribution, PC3 takes us to 66.5% cumulative contribution, and so forth. Continuing this, we see that we can explain 92% of the variance from just 8 variables. Therefore, we have reduced the number of variables from 13 to 8 with only an 8% loss of fidelity. To visualize the before and after effect of the principal components analysis process, we will plot two charts. The first will show a plot of the data using just the PC1 and PC2 principal components. The second will plot the data using all of the principal components. The first line of code is for the first chart, where we want to plot out only columns 1 and 2 of the wine PCA data, because those represent PC1 and PC2 respectively. We also add a color option indicator by col in R to distinguish the three different classes with three different colors. The second line of code is for the second chart, where we want to plot out all of the principal components. We still keep the same three colors. We can see two plots. The plot on the left shows the results on PC1 and PC2 only. The plot on the right shows the results of including all of the principal components. Because the screen only includes two dimensions, R only plots the first two principal components. Therefore, the two plots are identical. To make things more interesting, we can plot PC3 and PC4 only, and compare to the plot of all of the principal components. Note how the plot of PC3 and PC4 does not explain as much of the variance in the data. We see that, by the way, all the data points are stacked on top of each other. We have thus lost our power to distinguish among the three cultivars of wine, CV1, CV2, and CV3. In this video, we covered an introduction to dimension reduction and demonstrated the process using an example data set. We showed how to check for correlation and execute the principal components analysis process in R. We also displayed the results using different plots to show the power of PCA. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe to the channel.